Many blessings, young one. We hope to stay for the celebration, but we must be off. The human who owns our building has decided to sell it for storage space. We can't afford to live anywhere else here, so we're leaving Denerim.
The Ostagar ruins. The army camp there is calling for laborers.
We wanted to look for work in High Ever.
But that's just not possible. All three of us in one room with your father, you, and your new husband? Are you crazy?
What my husband means is you're very generous, but we don't need charity to solve our problems.
Many thanks. Again, blessings on your day.
Wait! Can I talk to you a moment?
I apologize for my parents. They're too proud to accept help, much less ask for it. My parents will labor in the army camp, and they'll expect me to do the same, but I don't like the idea of being surrounded by human soldiers who haven't seen a woman in months. I would, but my father would have to believe I have a future here. Of course, but I can't imagine anyone here has much to spare. We'd need another 3 silvers to make it to High Ever. And if we got another 10 silvers, we could rent a house here. Maybe one large enough to start a business. But that's just dream talk. Nobody has that much money, and if they did, why would they give it to us? Where did you get this much money? Never mind. I'm sure not talking you out of this. Thank you! Thank you so much! You saved my family! I love you! Now I just have to handle the parents.
Well, if it isn't my lucky cousin. Care to celebrate the end of our independence together?
Are you insane? Where would you go? Into the woods to live with the Dalish elves? Remember your father's stories about happy wood elves living far from humans? Valendrian calls them Dalish.
Not that we'd know where to find them. Besides, why would you run?
Apparently your groom's a dream come true.
My bride sounds like a dying mouse.
She's not ugly, exactly. I don't know, maybe it's just nerves.
Let's go introduce you to your dreamy betrothed before you say I do.
Alms for a man who can no longer work. Show a bit of charity this day. Bam. Spare a coin for a man who was ruined trying to help his family. I worked on the docks, living day to day, never knowing if my family would go hungry. The humans always left us the dangerous work, in the high beams of the warehouses or in the water. I was rigged up, cleaning the side of a ship, when it drifted against another and my legs were crushed between. The human foreman had me hauled out and dumped in an alley. My sons didn't find me until day's end. So now I live on the charity of those who don't even have enough for themselves. May the Maker's eyes look down with love on your day.
Hey, you're gonna be late for your own wedding. What if you're wrong? How terrible that would be. The bride is supposed to be pretty and caring. And definitely not late. Only humans don't care about being respectful. Father said it this morning when my brothers didn't want to get out of bed. He said they were acting like lazy humans. I guess they're pretty lazy.
It's a party, isn't it? Grab a whore and have a good time. Savor the hunt, boys. Take this little elven wench here. So young and vulnerable.
Touch me and I'll gut you, you pig.
Please, my lord. We're celebrating weddings here.
Silence, worm.
I know what you're thinking, but maybe we shouldn't get involved. Let's try to be diplomatic, shall we?
What's this? Another lovely one come to keep me company.
Ha! You hear that, Vaughn?
Ha! Do you have any idea who I am?
Insane! This is Vaughn Orion, the Arl of Denerim's son!
What? Oh, Maker.
You've a lot of nerve, Knife Ears. This'll go badly for you.
Oh, I really messed up this time.
It'll be all right. He won't tell anyone an elven woman took him down.
I hope so. I should get cleaned up.
Is everybody else all right?
I think we're just shaken. What was that about?
Looks like the Arl's son started drinking too early. Well, let's not let this ruin the day.
This is Valora, my betrothed.
I am a lucky man to be so warmly welcomed.
I'm sure the two of you have a lot to discuss.
Well, here we are. Are you nervous? I thought I'd stay calm, but finally seeing you has made me... Well, let's just say I'm not calm. Uneventful, thankfully. The trade caravan we accompanied had little of value. I think that kept the bandits away.
Come on, cousin. We should let them get ready.
We'll see you two in a bit. Don't disappear on us.
Or we'll come find you.
Don't look now, but we have another problem. Another human just walked in. Could be one of Vaughn's or just a random troublemaker. Either way, we need to move him along before someone does something stupid. Let's do this quickly.
Good day. I understand congratulations are in order for your impending wedding. What manner of unpleasantness might you be referring to? I'm sorry, but I have no intention of leaving. She keeps her composure even when facing down an unknown and armed human. A true gift, wouldn't you say, Valendrian?
I would say the world has far more use of those who know how to stay their blades. It is good to see you again, my old friend. It has been far too long.
I was hardly forthcoming, and for that I apologize.
May I present Duncan, head of the Grey Wardens in Ferelden. They are a great order of warriors, child, sworn to protect our world from the Darkspawn. But my question remains unanswered. Why are you here, Duncan?
The worst has happened. A blight has begun. King Kaelin summons the Grey Wardens to Ostagar to fight the Darkspawn Horde alongside his armies.
Yes, I had heard the news. Still, this is an awkward time. There is to be a wedding. Two, in fact.
So I see. By all means, attend to your ceremonies. My concerns can wait for now.
Very well. Children, treat Duncan as my guest. And for the Maker's sake, take your places.
Please, do not let me interrupt further. We shall speak more later.